Welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the complete important questions of CBSE Class 10th Mathematics. Okay, now let's begin our video. Coming to the chapter 1, LCM and HCF problems are one of the most important questions. So I'll give you an example. They'll ask you, find the LCM and HCF of so and so number, okay? And they may also ask some other kind of questions such as LCM into HCF is equal to number 1 into number 2, okay? So these kind of questions will also be appearing. I'm repeating the question, LCM into HCF is equal to, they'll be giving two different numbers. We need to prove that LCM into HCF is equal to the multiplication of two given numbers. So these kind of questions will be repeating every year. And second most important topic of chapter 1 is they'll ask you to find whether the given number is irrational or not. For example, prove that root 10 is irrational number, okay? Or is root 5 an irrational number? If yes, prove it, okay? Then you have to solve the entire problem. So coming to the chapter 2, the most important questions, type of questions is they'll ask you to solve the equation. For example, 5x cube plus 10x square minus 2x plus 5 is equal to what? Like, you need to solve this equation and you need to derive the solution. Okay, so such kind of questions are very important from chapter 2. They may ask some other questions also, such as obtain all the zeros from given equation. Okay, for example, obtain all zeros from 6x cube plus 5x square minus 10x minus 3 is equal to the value. Okay, we need to obtain all the zeros from the given equation. Okay, so now let's see what are the most important topics from chapter 3. Coming to chapter 3, the boat and stream problems are very important. Okay, coming to this particular boat and stream problems, we will be having the formulae. Okay, the standard formula. If you follow all the formula, if you have the formula always in your mind, you can solve any problem very easily. Okay, so boats and streams are very important. Coming to the boats and streams, there can be many kinds of questions which they may ask you. They may ask you what is the speed of the boat, what is the speed of the stream, and how much time will it take to reach the particular point to this boat when it is traveling in specific speed. So many kinds of questions may be asked coming to boats and streams. So what you need to do is you have to really be good with all the formulae of boats and streams. Okay, so coming to the chapter 3, next important topic is distance and time. Okay, they'll ask you what is the distance of the particular object and how much distance did you travel or how much time it took to reach a particular point. So distance and speed, like from this also formula are very important. And these two, boat and streams, and time and distance, like distance, are very important. Okay, so there are standard formulas. Make sure you learn all the standard formula to get a good marks. So now let's see what are the most important topics from chapter 4. Coming to chapter 4, they'll ask you to find the roots of the equation. For example, find the roots of the given equation 2 under root 2 x square plus 8 x minus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. Okay, I'm repeating the question. Square root of 2 x square plus 8 x minus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. Okay, then we need to derive the root, like find the root of the given equation. Okay, and next kind of very important topics from the chapter 4 are age problems. Okay, so son age is given, father age is given. They'll ask you to find the difference between the two ages, difference between the age of father and son. Or they may ask you, they may be giving you what is the son's age, and they'll ask you to find the father's age, or vice versa. They may give you the father's age and they'll ask you to find the son's age, or they will ask you, like, they may ask you any problems from ages. Okay, so make sure you're very good and you have logical thinking, because coming to the age problems, age related problems, you should be very fast. Try to understand the question very well. Okay, the questions will be logical. Don't get confused. Read the question 2 to 3 times. Okay, so coming to the next important part of chapter 4 is, they'll be giving you train related problems. There is a pole and train is traveling at a specific speed. How much time will it take to cross the pole or reach the pole? Or for example, they may ask you, there is a pole, pole is point B, train is at point A. How much time will it take for train to travel from point A to point B when it is traveling at a specific speed? So such kind of questions will be asked. Okay, and you should be really good with train problems. There'll be so many kind of problems coming to trains. They'll be asking you, a man is traveling opposite direction towards the train, and how much, when will they meet at a specific point? Or they may ask you, when will the train reach from point A to point B? Or they may ask you, two trains are traveling in opposite directions, when will, like, which train will reach fast to its destination? So such kind of problems will be there. So be confident and learn all the formulae. They are very important. Okay, so coming to the chapter 5, they'll give you different kinds of questions, out of which I'm going to discuss only important questions. So coming to the chapter 5, they will ask you, what is the sum of the first 30 positive numbers? Or they may also ask you, what is the sum of, like, find the sum of first positive integers divisible by 6. They may also ask you, find the sum of first 20 positive numbers which are divisible by 2. So such kind of questions will be very, very important. It will be repeating every single year. So concentrate well on these particular questions. And coming to the next kind of questions, they will be asking you arithmetic progression questions and all. They'll ask you, which term of arithmetic progression, that is AP, is its first negative term? They'll be giving you a series. You need to find what is its first negative term, or what is its first positive term. For example, they have given you a series 121, 117, 113, so on. Find what is the first negative term which will occur in this given series. So such kind of questions are very important. Concentrate more. And now coming to the chapter 6, they will be asking you all the theorems. Like, they'll be giving you a theorem and they'll ask you, prove it. Okay, they'll give you a theorem. They'll be just giving a theorem statement. You need to prove it. Okay, it is very important. And next is, they will be giving you triangle and perpendicular questions. For example, triangle ABC is an obtuse angled triangle and AD is perpendicular to BC. Prove that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BC into BD. I am repeating the question. This is most important question. Triangle ABC is an obtuse angled triangle and AD is perpendicular to BC. Prove that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BC into BD. This is very important question. This kind of question should be appearing every single year. Okay. So, and the next important topic of this same chapter 6 is, they will be asking you the questions such as, prove that AB is perpendicular to BC or AC is equal to AC is perpendicular or parallel to BD, like this. Such kind of questions will be really repeating every year, okay? So now let's see what are the important questions you need to concentrate from chapter 7, okay? So coming to the chapter 7, they'll be asking you most of the questions relating to the triangle. Find the area of the triangle. Find the area of the given triangle. So such kind of questions are very important. And then they will also ask distance formula, okay? What is the distance formula of 2 points? What is the distance formula of 3 points? Such kind of questions also they'll be asking from chapter 7. And coming to the chapter 7, they also will ask you the questions from ratio, okay? Find the ratio in which the line segment joining the 2 points minus 3, 10 and 6, minus 8, which is divisible by minus 1, 6. This is very important question. I am repeating the question. Find the ratio in which the line segment joining the points of minus 3, 10 and 6, minus 8 and is divisible by the minus 1, 6. This kind of questions are also very important from the chapter 7. Okay. Now let's see what are the important questions from the chapter 8, okay? So, coming to the chapter 8, exercise 8.4 and exercise 8.3. Mostly every year the questions will be asked from these two exercises, exercise 8.4 and exercises 8.3, okay? So, coming to chapter 8, the questions from trigonometry are very important, okay? So, they will be asking you to solve the questions from the trigonometry, okay? So, coming to the next particular chapter, it is of chapter 9. And coming to the chapter 9, you need to concentrate on the questions such as, they will be asking you what is the value of tan 30 or tan 60 or tan like cos. They may ask you any questions, but they will ask you specifically to write the value of tan 30 or tan 60 or like, you know, tan cos. These kind of values they will be asking you coming to chapter 9, which is very important. Okay, now let's see what are the most important topics from chapter 10. Coming to the chapter 10, the theorems which are in chapter 10 are very important. Please concentrate on them. And they will also ask you to prove what is Pythagoras theorem, which is always very important. Pythagoras theorem you should never avoid. Learn to prove Pythagoras theorem. And then they'll give you a quadrilateral, okay? They'll give you a quadrilateral and questions will be asked on it. So now let's see what is the sample question which will be asked from quadrilateral. A quadrilateral ABCD is drawn to a circumscribe a circle at a point PQRS at side AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Prove AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. I am repeating this question. A quadrilateral ABCD is drawn and there is a circle at the point PQRS and at side there are AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Prove that AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. Okay. And they will also be asking you the questions such as what is the radii of the circles and two concentric circles are of radii 5 cm and 3 cm. What is the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle? Such kind of questions will also be asked. Okay. And now let's see what are the most important questions from chapter 11. Coming to the chapter 11, they will ask you to draw a tangent. Okay, so learn how to draw a tangent. And coming to the chapter 11, they will ask you the questions such as draw a triangle ABC with sides BC is equal to 7 centimeters, angle B is equal to 45 degrees, angle A is equal to 105 degrees, then construct a triangle whose sides are 4/3 of times to the corresponding sides of triangle ABC. Okay, I'm repeating the question. They will ask you to draw a triangle with the side BC is equal to 7 centimeters, angle B is equal to 45 degrees, angle A is equal to 105 degrees, and then you need to construct the triangle whose sides is 4/3 of times to the corresponding of the sides of triangle ABC. And you must learn how to draw a tangent. It is very important. Okay. So now let's see what are the important chapters coming to chapter 12. Topics coming to chapter 12. Okay. So coming to chapter 12, you need to solve the questions regarding the radius. Okay. They are very important. And they'll also ask you to draw a diagram with the area of a shaded region. They'll mostly give you the questions related to the area of shaded region, such as shaded triangle, shaded parallelogram, like that, okay? So, coming to the chapter 13. Chapter 13, you must always be very good with the 3D kind of questions. You have to learn all the formulae from 3D, okay, 3D related questions. Coming to chapter 14, you have to be very good with the ogive graph. Be very good with it, with that, okay, and also learn the formula of mode, median and mean, okay. So they are very important. Coming to the chapter 14, I'm repeating, mean, medium and median mode, like mean, median and mode are very important. Be very careful and be very good with the formulae, okay. So coming to the chapter 15, they'll be asking you the questions on dice, okay. For example, there are two dice. What is the probability that when we throw the two dice, the total will be 12 or the total will be 8, okay. So such kind of questions will be asked, and the probability kind of questions. And there'll be questions on cards. There'll be 52 cards. How many, like, probability of getting an ace, or, you know, like this kind of questions, okay. So hope you found this video very useful. Thank you so much for watching till end. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more such wonderful videos. You know what to do. Subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon, like and share this video with all your friends and classmates. All the very best. Hope you do very well in this exam, and I'm going to do more and more such kind of videos with more and more important questions, tips how to crack this exam with good marks and all that. Subscribe, like, hit the bell icon and share. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching and all the best for your exams.